Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 126 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 201 questions and 3 case studies in previous videos. Today we going to look into question number 202 and 203. Before we proceed with today's topic, I would like to inform you that we are providing online instructor-led hands-on Azure trainings. If interested, please feel free to reach me on this WhatsApp number. Question 202. You have an Azure subscription that contains two virtual machines, as shown in the following table. Virtual machine 1 has Windows Server 2019. It is hosted in West Europe and IP address is 10.0.0.4. This is the local IP address. And DNS server is provided by Azure. Similarly, we have virtual machine 2, which is also having 2019 operating system, hosted in West Europe and is having local IP address 10.0.0.5. And that is also using DNS server from Azure. You perform a reverse DNS lookup, means NS lookup command, for 10.0.0.4 from VM2, means we are running a NS lookup command on this virtual machine. Which fully qualified domain name will be returned? Let's see this practically using the Azure portal. We are in Azure portal. We'll click on resource groups. We go to our resource group. I have already created two virtual machines. Click on resource visualizer. We have VM1 and VM2. We'll be connecting to VM2. We'll connect to VM2 using the public IP address. Open remote desktop connection. Type the IP address, click connect. We will open the command prompt. Type ipconfig to check the IP address of this machine. So the local IP address of this machine is 10.0.0.5. We'll do NS lookup or reverse lookup to 10.0.0.4. which is our virtual machine 1. Hit enter. Here we will see the internal DNS name vm1.internal.cloudapp.net. Let's go back to question. Therefore, option D, vm.internal.cloudapp.net, is the correct answer. Let's go to next question. Question 203. You have an Azure subscription that contains a policy-based virtual network gateway named GW1 and virtual network named VNet1. You need to ensure that you can configure point-to-site connection from an on-premise computer to VNet1. Which two actions should you perform? Each correct answer present part of the solution. We may have two type of virtual networks. One is policy based, another is route based. Second, we need to configure point to site connection, and we may have another which is site to site connectivity. So here we are talking about point to site connectivity. Let's understand the virtual network gateway in detail by going to learn.microsoft.com. We are on learn.microsoft.com on the VPN gateway page. What is Azure VPN gateway? Azure VPN gateway is a service that can be used to send encrypted traffic between an Azure virtual network and on-premises locations over the public internet. Why use VPN gateway? Here are some of the key scenarios. The first scenario, if we want to have site-to-site connection, then we can use it, or if we want to have point to site connection. In this case, we are looking for point to site connectivity. For point to site connection, VPN over OpenVPN, IKEv2 or SSTP protocol can be used. This type of connection lets you connect to your virtual network from a remote location. Like we can connect from our home PC or any conference room. Planning and design. We will understand about point to site VPN connection planning. Under the planning table, you will see point to site connectivity and site to site connectivity planning. For point to site connectivity, you can connect from your home PC, any cloud service or virtual machines. It only supports route based routing, and which is called dynamic routing as well. But in site to site connectivity, it supports the policy based routing as well. Therefore, in our question case, we have policy based routing, and that will not be supported for point to site connectivity. Let's go back to question. Since the existing virtual network gateway GW1 is a policy based virtual network, therefore we will have to delete it first. So this will be the first answer. Then we'll create a route based virtual network gateway. Then only we will be able to configure a point to site connection between on-premise computer to VNet1. So option E and option C are the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.